In the 3rd century, about 300 years after Jesus walked the earth, the Roman Empire had grown so decadent, sexual promiscuity ran rampant, greed, lust, power, pride. This culture had become so decayed and so depraved that men and women who had encountered the love of Christ and desired to pursue Him wholeheartedly and passionately, saw this decadent society, saw this decay in society, and decided to remove themselves from society in order to seek God and set themselves apart for God. They'd organize themselves in communities and worship together and fast together and pray together and seek God together. The movement lasted for about 200 to 300 years and really set the stage for Christian monasticism to take hold within the known world. This movement was centralized around northern Egypt. There were various other different places, but northern Egypt was the main hub of this movement. And this movement was known as the Desert Fathers and the Desert Mothers. So, why the Desert Fathers? What interests me about the Desert Fathers? Well, the Desert Fathers, though they became influential church theologians and taught about God, their point wasn't to become influential theologians. Their point was to encounter the presence of God. To the Desert Fathers, the will of God wasn't so much about accomplishing the things God asked you to do as it was about becoming His presence here on earth. And the way you became His presence here on earth was disciplining your life to create space to encounter His presence. What they unlocked were incredible miracles, incredible testimonies, incredible stories of people being saved, set free, and delivered, and operating in incredible power. But the point wasn't to operate in that. The point was to be united with His Spirit. And in being united with His Spirit, they encountered His presence, and in encountering His presence, their hearts were changed, and they did great things because of the humility they walked in. So, what did the Desert Fathers teach? Well, the Desert Fathers taught multiple disciplines that they instilled within their lives, disciplines like silence. You see, the practice of silence was about removing external noise to clarify the internal life, what the heart was thinking. With external noise so loud, and today we have music, we have television, we have radio, we have all these things, we're bombarded by a cacophony of sound, and it drowns out what's in our inner life without even realizing that what's in our heart already drowns out the voice of God. So removing themselves from society, they set themselves into solitary places in order to practice silence, to expose what their heart was thinking in order to deal with the thoughts of their heart. They practiced disciplines like solitude. Solitude was the removal from one place to another in order to remove yourself from the thing that brought you comfort. Where silence dealt with the internal life and what you were thinking about, solitude dealt with the things that you desired and craved. So you would remove yourselves from the things that you needed in order to find what brought you comfort, in order to attach yourself to Christ to find comfort in Him. After all, the Holy Spirit is called the Great Comforter. They taught disciplines like fasting. Fasting was about retraining desire. Think about this. You go into a restaurant, you look at the menu, you go through all the choices, and there's some 500 menu items on the menu, and you go through this thought process of, what do I feel like eating? We have an emotional attachment to food that fasting can help to expose. See, fasting dealt with the emotional life. So fasting helped to retrain the spiritual life. It helped to retrain the interior life to desire Christ. Another discipline the Desert Fathers taught was detachment. See, silence, solitude, and fasting, all of those things would prove to you the attachments you had in life, the things that you looked at for comfort, the things you looked at that you desired, the things you looked at that you were attached to. Detachment was the practice of willfully detaching yourself from things that you had, thoughts that you would embrace, pain, anger, lust, desire, and retraining those attachments to be attached to God, to be united with His Spirit. Come with me on a journey where we discover these men and women, the things that they taught, the lives that they lived, the miracles that they performed. On this journey, you'll learn about uniting yourself with Christ, humbling yourself before others, walking in a life of love and power, and only caring about being recklessly abandoned to His presence. These men and women have been integral to my walk with Christ and forming the way I approach the spiritual life. I hope to share them with you and the things that I've learned and the things that they can teach you. Come with me on this journey, encounter the presence of Christ, and have your heart radically impacted by who He is and how much He loves you. Blessings. Hope to see you again. Thank you.